How to develop a design language in architecture? When it comes to learning it, there is a great master of 20th century, none other than Frank Lloyd Wright. Frank Lloyd Wright built more than 1,000 projects in his career, in which 400 projects are still standing. F.L. Wright built the Prairie style, and because of this architecture style, 8 of his projects are in UNESCO World Heritage Site. Among these, F.L. Wright built Ruby House in 1909, which is a wonder of architecture homes. It is known for its horizontal proportions, painted glass and cantilever projections, but this house has something more to offer. In the last video, we have learned the theory of the Prairie style. In this video, we will learn the practical implication of this style. F.L. Wright always emphasizes the architectural language. He said one should always follow his or her own language in architecture. We will learn how F.L. Wright developed his style of architecture through the project Ruby House. There are various ways to start the design, but F.L. Wright always start the house with the fireplace. It is the starting point of the house. Let's build the tree scheme of the Prairie style. There are four ways to place the fireplace, and it is placed on the horizontal side of the house. This fireplace is attached to the living area of the house. Now this arrangement has various extensions in which the services are attached to the opposite side of the living area, making the fireplace the hypothetical center of the house. We can make four different extensions of the house as per the arrows shown. Now let's elaborate on one of the composition. In this we will fix the core unit, and now we will extend the services of the house. These services are placed in three different arrangements, such as extensions from the one edge of the house, then from the mid of the house, and from the other end of the house. Now let's elaborate other services of the house. To do so, we have three more extensions of the house in which we can place the services attached to the core of the house, then to the mid of the house, and to the other end of the house. This way we can build various options for the house. This is the composition of the Ruby House. If we trace the plan of this composition, we can understand the geometrical hierarchy of the space, in which the fireplace is the hypothetical center of the house. One side of the house is a living area, whereas the other side of the house has services. We can further explore this tree and make various combinations. The basic composition can lead to 89 different architecture compositions, in which every interior has a different experience. Let's see the plan of the house. Here the fireplace is the center of the house, in which two extensions are very evident. One is dedicated to the living area of the house, whereas other is dedicated to the services of the house. The entry of the house is hidden, which has a low roof and a dark entrance, and it leads to the play area of the house, in which one side of the house has a billiards room, whereas the other side of the house has a kids play area. This house has two entrances, one is for the public and one is for the car parking. This house has a garage in which three cars can be parked. The center of the house has a staircase which leads to the upper floor of the house, and it is attached to the extra services of the house, such as laundry area, heating machine area, and the servant room. We can clearly see the architectural language of the Prairie style. Services are attached on the one side of the house and the living area is on the other side of the house, and they both are connected to the central core of the house. The upper floor of the plan has similar functions. One side of the house has services, whereas other side of the house has a living area. The center of the house is for the vertical services, which is attached to the kitchen area and the dining area of the house. F.L. Wright further extended the house with the balconies and the shaded cantilever projections. This 20 feet cantilever of the house is still a structural marvel of the house. The top floor of the house has all the rooms, which includes the master bedroom, children's bedroom, and the guest bedroom. And they all are connected with the staircase service. And this house has a balcony view on all four sides of the house. Let's see the schematic section of the house. The top floor of the house has rooms. The first floor of the house has living area, kitchen, servant rooms, and the ground floor of the house has a play area and the garage. The fireplace is the hierarchical center of the house, and the center is the core block of the house. This core block is extended upward and makes a room at the top floor of the house. F.L. Wright also emphasizes the landscape of the house, in which the house is gradually decreasing to the surrounding context of the site. Wright emphasizes the horizontal proportions of the house. If we see the details of the walls, F.L. Wright uses two different types of mortar, in which horizontal mortar has a yellow color, whereas vertical mortar has the same color as of the brick. This way he emphasizes the horizontality of the house. Cantilevered roof for the balcony were added. The entrance of the house is narrow, which leads to the billiards room on the ground floor, which has a high ceiling. This way Wright emphasizes the sensory experience of the house. The living room of the house has longer proportion, which also emphasizes the horizontality of the house. F.L. Wright is the master of hidden architecture. His architectural language makes the house beautiful and elegant. If you follow this hidden architecture language into your project, your client will appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to learn more about the Prairie style, you can watch this particular video. Don't forget to hit the like button. See you in the next video. Salute.